Hello, everyone. Thank you all so much for joining me. I'm so sorry to have been gone for so long. I've been in the hospital. No, it was not the swine flu. It was, in fact, the sinus infection from hell. After the vampires, with their long hypodermic needles, finished draining my blood, it was determined that I am 100% healthy. I'm feeling great. I'm back and ready to continue the true stories of the final five anoles to be relocated from Anole Alley. Also, sadly, this episode, episode 8, is the first of the final five episodes of Anole Alley. A few anoles are still hanging around, like this one, on top of the old hutch that Caesar the iguana used to call home. This looks like a young male. He'd be a perfect candidate for relocation. So would this one, another young male. He continues to pursue the object of his desire. Tripod, the female, who calls this old window blind home. But of course, she's not interested in a mate right now. She must conserve her energy for the winter and the colder weather. This season's new crop of anoles has done very well. It's a shame some of them will soon be losing their home. And potentially, their lives. To predators, like this young stray cat, who I have personally witnessed her catch and devour several small anoles. Fortunately, this little anole has escaped the clutches of an almost certain death. But the young anole on top of the hutch has just now begun to face his fair share of danger. This mockingbird is searching for a meal. A nice, fat anole would certainly hit the spot. The anole has to take cover and remain perfectly still to avoid being detected and eaten by the hungry bird. The young anole survives his bird encounter. He and four more of his comrades anxiously await their trip to their new home. Safe in their containers. One of them is molting and missing half his tail. All unharmed, but they nervously await their fate. Welcome to the Ridge. We now call this place home, and it's about to be the new home of the final five. The first of them to breathe the fresh air of the Red Hills is the youngster in molt. He's confused and doesn't quite know what to do next. After getting his bearings straight, By instinct, he begins to head for higher ground. After a gentle nudge, he's off into the cover of the brush. Up next, and out of the box, a small female. She's very difficult to see down in the leaf litter. Thank you, dear, for pointing her out to me. There she is. Now, it's the other young male's turn to go. He wastes no time searching for cover. He remains cautious and appears to think about every move instead of just bolting away blindly. The next one out, another young male. It's the handsome fellow from the window. He's looking great, and off into the cover. And last, but certainly not least, it's the very brave little survivor named Tripod. Yes, Tripod. She and the rest will all find their places along the ridge and begin anew. It's going to take them some time to adjust. And work out the pecking order. Before long, they will have blended in to become part of something new. A new life in a new, inviting, thriving ecosystem, tucked away up here in the red hills of South Alabama. Thanks for watching. See you next time.